Okay, time for a Friday Reads, and I have read and I'm reading and going to read so much that I took notes this time. I normally don't take notes, but I didn't want to forget anything, and I will probably still forget something, but let's just get right into it. First, if you didn't know, Shelf Space is hosting a readathon next month. I will be participating. I have not made my TBR yet, but you have to sign up by May 24th if you want in. And I'm not like a captain or anything, but like, I don't want you to like see my TBR in a few weeks and be like, I want to join, but you can't. So if you want to do that, I will link some announcement videos below. So many of my friends have done announcement videos. It's going to be fun. You can literally mood read. You can follow prompts. The whole point is to be with friends and read books. I love it. It's one of my favorite readathons. We did it in December. It was so motivating. It was so fun. So just wanted to do that real quick. And now let's talk about the books. And then I have a tiny, again, little mini haul. Because I went on vacation, and when I go on vacation, you go to local bookstores, right? Like, that's what you do. So let's get into it. The first one I talk about more in a vlog, but I'll just mention it real quick. All You Can Ever Know by Nicole Chung. This was the memoir that I've been reading, and I really enjoyed it. I talk more about it in the vlog, so you can see it then or when I talk about it in the wrap-up. But this was something I did with audiobook. It's a book I've been meaning to read since, like, 2018. And I finally got around to it, so that's just, like, so satisfying when you finally read something that's been want to read for, like, 3 years. I'll also talk about, actually, real quick, because I also talk about it in the vlog, Burning Roses. This is really good. I think I'd give it, like, maybe a 3.5, 3 out of 5 stars, something like that. And I talk about it a lot in the vlog, because I do have issues in that I just wanted something else than what I was given. And I do think that I have thematic disconnect from it because of the baggage I bring to the story, because we all do that, right? Because there's a lot of thematic about parental forgiveness, and I don't necessarily think, like, one of the things the parent figures are guilty of in here is being self-centered or selfish, and, like, forgetting about their families, and I don't think that they learn that lesson. I don't know. I'm very harsh sometimes with this theme. It can be done so well, and other times I'm just like, and that's one of my reasons. But also, one of my big issues is we have these two amazing characters, in one's in Chinese folklore and one's in Western folklore, and the whole idea is that they're these middle-aged women doing stuff together, and we don't really see them doing stuff together. It's much more retrospective, and that's not bad, but it's not what I wanted. So I talk about it more in the vlog. I think it's good. It wasn't what I hoped it would be, but it was still a good time. And now, the book that I did finish, Wild Seed by Octavia Butler. This book got me wanting to read Sorrowland, which we'll talk about in a bit, and The Fifth Season, which we'll talk about in a bit. How have I not been reading more Octavia Butler, guys? I'm so excited. I'm going to read the second book next month. It's already on the TBR. I'm very excited. I don't really know how to explain why I really like it. Because I do think there are reasons why you wouldn't. There's a writing style to Octavia Butler that I really enjoy and eat up. I don't know if I'm going to describe it correctly, but to me it feels like it's a very, like, purposefully minimalistic approach to storytelling. And I really like that mainly because you get more, for me, like, the atmosphere, you get more to the point of, like, what people are thinking and responding and doing. But that also means sometimes there were moments where I'm like, I would like to understand how we emotionally went from this state to this state, and I didn't always get that. But other times, because of the time span of the story, you have these, like, really interesting arcs. I really liked the fantasy sci-fi elements that we were exploring and the time period in which we were exploring it in. We kind of are in different points of history. One is the late 1600s, another one is somewhere in the 1700s, and then we have 1800s. Almost all of it's in America, and we start from Virginia and go into, like, Louisiana in the South. And we follow a main character who's a Black woman from Africa. And I don't know, I just really liked that. I could tell it's the start of something. Like, as a standalone book, I don't think I care about it that much. But as, like, the beginning of something, I am so intrigued. And honestly, I couldn't put it down. Like, the writing style for me is just so, I don't know, it's smooth for me. It just goes, I can keep reading, it keeps me engaged. And I don't know, I really liked the main character. I really liked her powers. She has such cool powers. And I don't know, I'm very excited to discuss it at book club because I know for a fact it didn't work as well for one other person. And I have a feeling it's going to be one of those books that like is going to work so differently for different people. And I think that's going to lead to great discussion. And so I'm really excited about that, really excited to pick up the sequel. So that's the thing I finished. So now onto the things that I'm working on because of Wild Seed. I picked up fifth season and it's this is a perfect book. Okay, yes, I'm only this far in on my reread, but every sentence I love, okay? I love it so, so much. I like posted this on Instagram with my cat because my cat was being really cute. I don't even know. I should probably explain the fifth season, probably. It's a world where there's always an apocalypse, like every so often. Like in the back, there's an appendix of different like seasons. Like that's what you call like the fifth seasons all get names based off what caused them. So there's some that was caused by like plagues or volcanoes. There's one called the Wandering Season. There's the one called the Season of Yellow Seas. Like basically this world for reasons goes through apocalyptic events. And we start this book at the beginning of an apocalyptic event. But as the book clearly tells you, that's not the important part. And we start off with a grieving mother and it goes from there. And there are other perspectives, and every perspective is very interesting, very revealing. We mainly all have perspectives of people with this power to control the earth and the vibrations of the earth, which is a very feared power. And because of that, these powerful people have been basically turned into indentured slaves, essentially. So there's a lot of oppression explored in this thematically. There's a lot of survival, a lot of motherhood. That's very similar to things that have happened in Wild Seed. But I mean, I really like Octavia Butler's writing. I love N.K. Jemisin's writing. I love the narrative formats she uses. I love her authorial voice. I think there, by the time you're seeing this, there might be a Jemisin World Hopper video in the world where I am gushing about this with other people who love Jemisin, and I'll just point you that way. You cannot like Jemisin's work. We can still be friends. But just know how much I love her and be gentle with me when you tell me you don't, okay? Like, let's just have that nice respect with each other. Because when I don't know someone's writing who I love more. It's just really the simple part of it. So, reading that. It's great. I'm also still reading Anne of Green Gables, and I did get a little further. I was talking to Stephanie, because I'm like, oh my gosh, this little arc just happened, and I was so stressed, but so happy with how it turned out. And there's this kind of competitive relationship between Anne and this guy, Gilbert? Is that his name? I don't know. I'm pretty sure maybe if my like storytelling radar's right, he's supposed to eventually become a love interest. I could be wrong. I'd be totally fine with it staying like rivalry to friends or something like that. Like that's what I want for sure. And it reminds me so much of me and one of my best friends growing up because we were always really competitive in school. Although like, I don't know. I didn't like dislike him as much as Anne dislikes Gilbert. Like, but I like reading this sometimes when I get home from work and I'm just like, I just want to see what Anne's doing in this chapter now because they're very episodic and there are like little arcs, but I'm really glad I bought a copy and just thoroughly enjoying this because I mean, thematically, I'm reading some like dark stuff. So it's nice to have just like day in the life of Anne in Canada, you know, like really chill. And then I'm reading Sauraland. I don't know why this happened. I think it was because hockey was happening and the guys were really stressed. We did win the game, but they were really stressed. And so I really couldn't get into the fifth season because there was too much noise around me. So I'm like, well, let me try reading something else. I just finished Wild Seed earlier and I was like, let's try Sauraland. I've been wanting to read it. So it was kind of one of those, read it, Angela. And instantly pulled in. This is thematically very similar in terms of motherhood. And like, I have so much motherhood, like Burning Roses, Fifth Season, Wild Seed, Sauraland, so much motherhood. I am not a mother unless you count my cats, which I don't, but so much. And this story is so creepy and so good and so intriguing. This might be my favorite work by them. I have read An Unkindness of Ghosts and I have read The Deep, and this is very intriguing. I have so many questions. I really like the writing. I really like the character perspectives. It also happens to have like this part of the story where there's a lot of survival, and I'm a sucker for survival in stories. Like I love that. So there's good mystery, there's good survival stuff. I really like the themes, I really like the writing. You know, I'm halfway through. I'm like itching to get back to it. It is so good. So that's what I'm reading on Kindle, and then I needed an audiobook. And I picked this up for the Reddit bingo, because on further reflection, all the chapters had to have multiple words in the title, and that's really hard to find. But you know what has that? Percy Jackson books. You know what I haven't read in a year? A Percy Jackson book, so Sea of Monsters. That's what I'm listening to, and you know, I might just consume all of these on audiobooks, because it's been pretty fun. I like the voice acting for it. Not much has happened. I'm only an hour or so in. Percy Jackson is my sibling's, like, favorite series, so I've been wanting to read it for them. Like, Percy Jackson is to them as Harry Potter was to me, is essentially how it was. Like, it's how it works age-wise, too, but also, like, Percy Jackson, that series has good ADHD representation. Like, Rick Riordan went out of his way to try and make sure all sorts of children were represented in his books, and that really helped, I think, for my sibling feel seen. I mean, for years, they weren't diagnosed, and, like, I felt so bad, because that makes it so hard to get through school. But I have been dragging my feet because I just don't read middle grade, and I read the first one with my eyes, and it was fine. But I think listening to it is just going to be so much more fun for me because of the voice acting. Like, it's great. I can listen to it at 2x speed and not, like, miss anything, which is rare for me because my auditory retention is, like, this much. But so that's for the Reddit bingo and the audiobook I'm reading right now, because I got a big audiobook coming up next month with Stephanie. It's time to get back to Wheel of Time very soon. So those are all the things that I am currently reading. And now let's talk about the things that I want to read next. The last book that I have for my, like, Asian Readathon challenge vlog is Never Let Me Go. Again, do not tell me anything. Nothing. Just like, if you are curious about my thoughts for it, or, like, you had an experience with it, hold it. Hold it till I've read it. Okay? We'll put a pin in that. Don't want to be spoiled, guys. Really don't. I've been holding off, but I'm going to probably pick this up after I finish Sarland. That's what I'm planning. And then the last one I'll talk about is The Stars Are Legion. I think that's the name of it. It's by Cameron Hurley. I've been meaning to read this with a bunch of people this month. It's also for the Reddit bingo. It won't fit in any prompts for the readathon next month, so I should get it done this month. So I don't know much about it. I think there's, like, Amnesia, which is one of my favorite things. I liked Cameron Hurley's Light Brigade. So excited to try it out. So those are all the things that I've read, that I'm reading, that I plan to get to, and now for a mini haul that I got. So I went to, I think it's called, oh, I have a bookmark for it. It's called Crow Bookshop in Burlington. So in Burlington, there's this really cool, like, shopping center street. I think it's called Church Street. Yep. And the Crow is, like, kind of a used, I mean, I think it is a used bookstore, but also will sell things new. But I bought all of these used, and they were very pretty. Like, all three of these, as I'll show you, $33, which, like, one of them I think I spent more than I probably should have, but I was then at that point just, like, wanting to buy the Serotonin. The first one that caught my eye, Escaping Exodus by Nikki Drayden. I read The Prey of Gods. It was so good. This was, like, so cheap. It was, like, $4. I don't know. I really want to read it. Look at the cover. I'm so excited. I'm pretty sure this is the first one. If it's not, I'll buy the first one. But I think Escaping Exodus first, and then there's a one after it. But I really love The Prey of Gods. I know this is more sci-fi than fantasy, but I liked their prose style. I liked their imagination. Really excited to see what I find in this one. One that was on my 21 to read in 2021, Master of Poisons by Andrea Hairston. I don't know anything about it. I know it's a standalone, so that's rare. And I think it's based off African folklore, but I don't know if it's a specific country in Africa or if it's a bunch of different ones. In the front, it just says, weaves together African folk tales and post-colonial literature into unforgettable fantasy. So I don't know really exactly, but it's very pretty. I really like the cover, and I've been seeing it around, and I've been wanting to read it. So now it's on my shelf, and it's just, like, this is used. This said used on it. This is the one that was pricier. This is the one that was, like, $12. But for a hardback, like, for those who don't know, this hardback would have cost $28 before tax. Such a good deal. And the last one is because of Brittany from Books with Brittany. She's been talking about Vita Nostra. And this is a translation of a first book in a trilogy, I think. But it can work as a standalone. And it's the only English one out. And all I know is it's, like, a dark school setting that's real weird. So probably this is going to be, like, a fall vibe book for me. And this beautiful hardback, $9. Like, could not buy it. So even though there was only, like, one shelf of, like, science fiction fantasy books, and of course there's never Robin Hobb. There's never Robin Hobb for me to buy. I, like, look for it always, can never find it. But I was really happy with that little haul. I mean, I was very impressed with the selection that was available on just that one shelf. But yeah, that's the bookish updates from this channel. What are you planning on reading or playing or watching? Oh, speaking of watching, because I always forget this. I didn't put it on my sheet, so I forgot. We watched Invincible. So good. Thank you to the people in my Discord. I think this was specifically Travis, who is also a patron, for telling me to watch this show on my vacation because it was amazing. It was so good. If anyone wants to know my spoiler-free thoughts or spoiler thoughts, let me know. I'll gladly make a video. Maybe I'll make Ryan do it with me because we both watched it. I love superhero content. I love it when it's cheesy. I love it when it's subversive. This was kind of the perfect blend of both. So let me know if you want more thoughts on that, but I highly recommend it if, like, you're good with gore in your media and if you like superhero stuff. I don't think this is something you would enjoy if you don't like superhero stuff. That's my prediction, at least. And otherwise, for an emoji, I don't know, guys. Stack of books. Simple. I had a lot of books today. I'm sure the thumbnail is real, real big with books. And otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.